Upper body session here today. Bit of strength work. This is one of the heavier sessions of the week. Doing this when there's kind of a gap between matches and training. So we'll take you through it here today. Barbitals on some pull-ups, bit of snatching. And then we're going to finish off with a bit of conditioning work and roar. So yeah, let's do it. Okay, so back with another commentary here. Starting off this workout, this upper body workout with some power work. Med ball chest pass, just trying to get as much force into the ball as possible. Going for about 5 sets, 1 rep here. Then moving into the main strength work, so we're doing some bench pressing, of course. Reps and sets are slightly different today, so we're doing what we call a ladder scheme. So we're going down in reps, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. And each set you're adding on 1.25 kg each set. So I'm trying to finish up here at about 92.5-95% of a 1 rep max. So starting a wee bit lighter on it, but I think it's a really good way to develop strength in the bench press, and it's slightly different than what people usually do, so it's a nice change. Going to the next block of work then, we have some pull-ups. So going 6-8 reps on the pull-ups, then moving into a shoulder exercise, and we're going for a landmine press. Then the only other thing that I have here that didn't show was an ab rollout, but trying to pair up a kind of push, a pull in the core when doing upper body work here. Just trying to make sure you're doing the session as balanced as possible. Noticing this and doing it kneeling as well, just to add a bit of extra work to the core too, just for the stability side of it. This landmine variation is a really good shoulder press to try it if you haven't already. Next block of work then, moving into some dumbbell benching. I'm actually using kettlebells here just because we don't have the right weight for dumbbells. But kettlebells are actually quite a good alternative. You can see there I'm getting quite a deep stretch with the kettlebells. So it's quite good for, again, developing strength and then developing a bit of muscle too. Going anywhere from 6-8 reps with the kettlebells here. And then moving into some dumbbell or kettlebell rows, single arm. Again, trying to balance out the pushes and the pulls here. And the only other thing that I didn't show that I forgot to film was the pal off press. If you don't know what a pal off press is, check it out. It's a core exercise. It's probably one of the most underutilized core exercises there is. In terms of sets for these bits of accessory work after the benching, I just went for 2 sets today just because I was feeling a bit tired. But you can work anywhere from 2 sets right up to 4 depending on how you're feeling on the day. But the goal is to try and be moving a good bit of heavy weight today, because this is more of a strength session. So 6-8 reps and make sure it's a tough 6-8. And then of course finishing off an upper body session with a bit of arms. So we are going one man on hammer curls, going heavy hammer curls for about 8 to 10 reps, and then one man doing skull crushers. You can do it with the barbell, or you can do it with a kettlebell. You can see Aaron doing the variation with the kettlebell there. But really just trying to do any sort of arm exercise and any sort of tricep extension exercise here. Feel free to sort of switch up what movement you go for, but really this is more just get a bit of pump at the end of the session. So again, that's a session here, and what you're trying to do whenever you're doing upper body is make sure you're getting a good balance between pushing and pulling and pressing overhead. It's kind of the best way to, number one, make sure your body is well balanced, and you're not going to have any sort of asymmetries in the body as well. So that's something I always try and do, is just balance out. When you're doing a push, you do a pull, and then try and get an even amount of presses in as well overhead. And then finishing off by the conditioning work, 3 sets of 500 meters, just as fast as you can.
You all right?
Really good fried egg. Scrambled egg, I'd say, would be.
Morning coaching done. Going to get a haircut here, and then back in this evening again, in the green machine again. Green machine again.
Time to get a haircut here.
Boom.
I get a haircut up in case we're at a bit of fucking delay here.
That's really roll, man. Stop tensing your arms again.
I'm not getting the leg. The leg has to be.
Oh, of course. This is so anticlimactic. This is gonna be terrible as well.
What? Are you waiting for it?
I'm waiting on you. How you're fucking ruining everything here.
Right, guys, if you've been a long time subscriber of the channel, you've known that.
I think I'm going to finish up that vlog for today, just a short one. But yeah, just going through that upper body workout. So hopefully give you a few ideas of what you could do in your own session. But I think it was a good wee workout. I enjoyed doing it today. I was just feeling a bit wrecked from a couple of days of working there. But yeah, try it out. Let me know how it goes for you. But I think it's a great strength session to do for the upper body, especially if you're a Gaelic player. You need that upper body strength without a doubt. But yeah, thanks for watching. I'll hopefully have another video up tomorrow with some more amazing content, or at least I'll try to. But yeah, thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.